Good morning, everyone. My name is Gaurav Gupta, and today I've got the opportunity to speak about Mr. Subhash Chandra Bose. My name is known as Netaji. In Hindi, it means respected leader. He was an Indian revolutionary prominent in independence movement against British rule of India. He also led an Indian national force from abroad against Western powers during World War II. He was a contemporary of Mohandas Karamchand Gandhiji, at times an ally and at other times an adversary. Bose was known in particular for his militant approach to independence and for his push for socialist policies. He was the son of a wealthy and prominent Bengali lawyer. Bose studied at Presidency College, Calcutta, from which he was expelled in 1916 for nationalist activities in the Scottish Churches College. He then was sent by his parents to University of Cambridge in England to prepare for Indian civil services. But in April 1921, after hearing of the nationalist turmoil in India, he resigned his candidacy and hurried back to India. Throughout his career, especially in its early stage, he was supported financially and emotionally by an elder brother named Sarat Chandra Bose, a wealthy Calcutta lawyer and an Indian National Congress politician. Bose joined the non-cooperation movement started by Mohandas Karamchand Gandhiji, who was made the Indian National Congress powerful non-violent organization. Bose was advised by Gandhi to work under Chitta Ranjan Das, a politician in Bengal. There Bose became a youth educator, journalist and commandant of the Bengal Congress volunteers. His activities led to his imprisonment in December 1921. In 1924, he was appointed Chief Executive Officer of the Calcutta Municipal Corporation, with Das as Mayor. Bose was soon after deported to Burma because he was suspected of connections with secret revolutionary agents. Released in 1927, he returned to find Bengal Congress affairs in disarray. After the death of Das, Bose was elected President of Bengal Congress. Shortly thereafter, he and Jawaharlal Nehru became the two general secretaries of the Indian National Congress. Together, they represented the more militant left-wing faction of the party against the more promising right-wing Gandhi faction.